With regards to poverty, the political polarization from 2002 to 2003 was disastrous, especially the general strike. Remember, the conflict made the parties use informal tactics and those opposing the government used what they had, namely their economic muscle in Fedecámaras, CTV and PDVSA. As the productive sectors didn't produce, prices went up again and inflation hit nearly 40%. It was then that poverty reached its record high of 60%.
Remember that after the oil strike in 2003, the Chávez government got control of the national oil company PDVSA and fired 40% of its workforce. And ever since, the productivity of PDVSA went down. At any rate, the conflict between PDVSA and the state was resolved in favor of the state. And in particular, in favor of the Chávez government, which now controlled vast inflows of spectacular amounts of oil revenues. It's commonly said that it spent most of these revenues on the so-called misiones. And let's try to find out if that's true. Now, to find out how much was spent on the misiones, we found numbers in PDVSA's 2012 financial statement. Here on page 109, on the left, you have all the misiones and on top the years and how much PDVSA spent on these misiones. Now we put this into Excel to visualize it, and in one total we exclude a few things that we think are not misiones. So Fondo Miranda, Fondo Chino, y Fonden we don't think are misiones. Now we put these numbers into a diagram to visually compare them to the total oil revenues. So for example, in 2008, total oil revenues per person were around $3,500. The total social spending from the financial statement above was a bit over $500. And what we think you can consider misiones are around $400, around an eighth. So that's not particularly revolutionary. But let's see how poverty reduction went. Poverty was around halved from 2003 onwards as economic growth picked up again with the rise of oil prices. The trouble is that it's difficult to tell if poverty dropped because of economic growth, normal social services, or the misiones. But what we can do is we can compare Venezuela to similar countries in the region and see how it performed in terms of poverty reduction and growth. Now, for this we need the so-called terms of trade. Imagine I'm a country and I produce microphones. So if in 1 year I can sell my microphones for, let's say, $100, and then the next year I can sell the same microphones for $150, that means my terms of trade have improved, because I can sell the same thing more expensively. So terms of trade measure how the prices of what you export develop compared to the prices of what you import. Terms of trade are always relative to another year, okay? If you gained from how prices developed in between, they increase. If not, they decrease. Data on these terms of trade are available on the Google Public Data Explorer, and they are calculated by the World Bank and part of the World Development Indicators. The terms of trade data calculated by the World Bank is relative to the year 2000. It's immediately obvious that Venezuela had a terms of trade boom like none other. Compared to the year 2000, what Venezuela exports, oil, became 2.5 times more expensive compared to what it imports. I've randomly also selected Chile, Peru, Ecuador, and Uruguay. Note that Uruguay has no terms of trade boom whatever, Ecuador a little bit, and Chile is the closest to Venezuela. Let's see how these terms of trade booms translated to poverty reduction. It's immediately obvious that there is no relationship with what we've seen before. Uruguay, which didn't have a terms of trade boom at all, outperformed all of them. And Venezuela is actually completely down in the middle, performing very mediocrely. Additionally, remember that this peak in poverty in 2003 was really to do with the polarization that was brought about in no small part by Chávez himself. So the poverty reduction that Venezuela achieved for the oil boom that it experienced isn't overwhelming. And there is something darker to the Misiones as well. Remember how ISI made the economic development model dependent on the oil price, because it needed oil dollars for inputs. The lesson of the 80s and 90s was that Venezuela should try not to become so reliant on only the oil price. And not only has the Chávez government emptied the funnel, the FEM that we talked about in the last video, but with the Misiones it made social spending itself directly dependent on the oil price. And that, as an economic policy, is a very bad idea, because it makes social services dependent on the oil price. It would be much better to finance social services through normal taxation, because taxation works on the entire economy and thus isn't as susceptible to price shocks as oil is. But it's impossible to ignore that the Misiones are used as a political tool. Think about it. Why did Chávez not institutionalize the Misiones as a normal social service to be independent of who's in government, and thus ensure their longevity? To keep the Misiones hostage to politics in this way really only makes sense politically. Because you could, if you wanted, institutionalize the Misiones as a normal social service independent of government power. But to keep it dependent on the government's goodwill, so to say, has everything to do with creating dependence for political power.
Ven acá, papá. Ven acá, da la vuelta por aquí, da la vuelta por aquí. Déjalo quieto, déjalo quieto. ¿Qué tal? ¿Y este papel quién me lo manda?
Mi mamá.
Taratán, me tuve que ir de la pensión de donde estaba. Bueno, entonces yo le voy a pedir de una vez a Erika, ¿dónde está Erika? Mi ministra Erika, que vaya a hablar con Maribel para ayudar a Maribel, que tiene 3 hijos. Ajá. No tienen casa. Tendrán casa y vida, que te lo juro, ¿oíste? Ok, chócala pues. Más nada.